Wally was a very happy wombat who lives in a beautiful wombat sanctuary in Australia. Not all wombats are as lucky as Wally. There is much danger for wombats out in the world. Automobiles, forest fires, and unkind people are some of the biggest threats. Wally was rescued a few years ago after an automobile driver who was careless and going too fast hit Wally. Kind rescuers saw him laying on the side of the road and took him to the vet. Fortunately, Wally was only shook up and after a few days' rest at the vet's, was taken to this beautiful sanctuary where he now lives with many rescued wombats. The Wombat Sanctuary has many, many acres of beautiful land and several lovely buildings where the wombats can rest in comfort at night and get good food. You know, just by looking at a wombat, that they love good food. But then, who doesn't? Wally loves to wander and wanders all over this vast sanctuary land. He likes to wobble around with that wonderful wombat gait, thinking lovely thoughts. And sometimes he starts shuffling along because he makes up little tunes in his mind as he walks. Can't you just see him as he shuffles along with his little legs to a happy tune? Although Wally is usually happy, he can't help but think of all the other wombats out there who are in peril. And this makes Wally very sad. Not all wombats are as fortunate as Wally was to be rescued. The tireless and kind volunteers do the best they can, but more resources are needed to help the other wombats. This preys on Wally's mind, and he wishes that people would support all the wonderful organizations working so hard to help his fellow wombats. Wally had a good friend a few years ago named Winston. They were separated when Wally had his accident. Winston and Wally went everywhere together and were very close. Wally thinks about Winston a lot, and his heart wishes that he and his best friend could be together. Wally overheard the workers at the sanctuary talking about a large forest fire in his old area. Wally is beside himself with worry about his friend Winston. A group of volunteer rescuers are heading out to see if they can offer help and rescue after the firefighters have things under control. Wally's heart is breaking with worry about Winston's fate. As the days go by, there is no word. The workers at the sanctuary are worried about the volunteer rescuers who risk their lives so many times to help wombats and other animals in distress. Wally goes on his wandering walks, but his gait is slower, and no happy tunes are playing in his head. What if Winston is in trouble? Will the brave rescuers find Winston? Wally worries and worries. And when he gets back to his place at the sanctuary after his daily wandering, he just lays down, too heartsick to even eat his wonderful wombat food. One morning, Wally heard a stirring of whispering excitement amongst the workers. they got a radio call that the rescuers are on the way back to the sanctuary with many rescued wombats from the fire. Wally was afraid to let the excitement take him over. He hoped Winston was rescued and not injured or killed. Wally did not go wandering that morning. He waited and waited for the rescuers to come home. Then, shortly after lunch, in the far distance, a cloud of dust was seen from the rescue vehicles. Everyone was excited and talking and hugging each other because their friends, the rescuers, were coming home. But Wally was just watchful and hopeful. The dust cloud got bigger and closer. The vehicles arrived, and the tired, happy to be home, rescuers got out and started to carry in the wombats that they risked their lives to rescue. Some were injured or burned. They had bandages on and were gently carried into the sanctuary vet's office. Some were okay physically, but dazed. One by one, they carried the wombats into the sanctuary. Then Wally heard a familiar grunt and saw a rescuer carrying a wombat who had his leg wrapped in bandages. It was Winston. Wally was beside himself with joy. They found Winston, and he will be fine. Just a little burn on his leg. Wally had never felt so happy and started feeling that tune start in his head again. But this time, it was a very, very joyful tune. And Wally's gait was light and dancing as he followed the rescuer and Winston into the vet's office. Winston was fine, the vet said. Just needs a little rest and rehab. The next day, Winston was able to be out and about a bit. So, Wally and Winston spent the day together, catching up on wombat happenings. They were so happy to be together again. Wally will not have to go wandering around the beautiful sanctuary alone any longer. He has his friend, Winston, and they will have many wonderful wombat adventures together.